today I want to talk about E3. No, not about any particular conferences happening at the moment, but rather the purpose of E3 itself. As I remarked on Facebook about the content being shown at Electronic Arts' conference, a commenter remarked, E3 is meant for investors, not just the general market. As you can see, I did reply that while that might have been the original intent, that can no longer be claimed. But how accurate is that exactly? It's worth noting that E3 was originally spawned from the need to have a specific conference aside from the Consumers Electronics Show and the European Computer Trade Show, among others, in 1995, right when the PlayStation was about to be released and right as the majority of the game changers that would affect the industry, such as the Entertainment Software Ratings Board, were taking shape. At the time, the video game industry wasn't being treated with respect, and the idea was to provide, as Knowledge Industry Publications CEO Elliot Minksker put it, an interpretive event that would help retailers make smarter buying decisions by interacting with a wide range of publishers, vendors, industry influential, and opinion leaders in a focused show setting. So yes, investors were the initial target of the Electronics Entertainment Expo, or as we have come to call it, E3. However, over time, people outside of the industry, like bloggers and the average consumer, were spawning more in E3 shows. The organizers were afraid this was going to shut down E3, much like the Comdex trade show before it. So for the 2007 and 2008 shows, the show organizers announced a downsizing and limited attendees. The move was nearly universally panned, with the backfire moment being that because consumers had been removed from the event, there was little media coverage of what was going on. Basically, without the consumers there, publishers couldn't gauge interest in the projects directly. The organizers made efforts to restructure to meet both sides' needs, but due to companies pulling out of E3 showcases like Nintendo and EA, you could say their efforts haven't been 100% successful. E3 is still a major event, don't get me wrong. But it's gotten obvious the move to try to make things more about the investors hurt a lot more than it helped. So where does that leave us? Who should the participants of E3 focus on? Well, while you could argue that they need to appease the investors by making guaranteed games that'll make for sure profits, they also need to appeal to their market, the gamers themselves. We're getting tired of seeing the same franchises over and over at E3. Story modes and sports games aren't innovations, and honestly, it's the kind of thing I don't understand why they're even there. WWE's 2K games, I at least get that, since a good chunk of that entertainment vehicle revolves around story and psychology. But in football, soccer, and basketball? No. Just Dance 2018? Sorry, unless there's a way to use the 6-axis control scheme to do the whole dancing mechanic, I'm not interested anymore. Anything annualized at this point is guaranteed to make money, so unless there's a feature so revolutionary that you had to reinvent the entire engine just to get it to work, I don't want to hear about it. You want to know what I want to see if I were an investor? I want to see a Kingdom Hearts 3 release date since they've been teasing this game forever. I want to see Ubisoft develop a brand new IP that isn't in an open world and has structure. I want linear stories and gameplay to come back and provide those of us who need focus and structure a reason to play. I want to see EA give me a BioWare RPG that doesn't betray their original intentions and doesn't look like they spent all that time on Mass Effect Andromeda really making a spiritual successor to what the original trilogy was supposed to lead up to. I want Nintendo to give me a reason other than Zelda to buy the damn Switch. I want companies to show me stuff that isn't leaked weeks ahead of time, that shows they're trying something new, and God damn it, give me Cuphead already! That's just my opinion. After all, I'm a gamer, not a business-minded individual.
Do you have something you'd like to add to the conversation? Please leave a comment below, and if you like what you saw, please leave a thumbs up and ring that subscribe bell if you haven't already. Also, check out my Twitter to find out what I'm working on next, and please consider donating to my Patreon to get an influence on further episodes. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.